And joining us here at the console in the Mission Director Center is Tim Dunn. He was the NASA launch director for this flight. And Tim, congratulations, because the NASA administrator has just given you given you an award and some congratulations. And
Thank you, George.
Tell us briefly what did he say to you?
Well, it was just a special opportunity for us as a launch team to have the administrator with us. He sat with us on console and recognized the team after we had successful GRAIL A and GRAIL B separation. So it's a special moment that the team's enjoying right now with the NASA administrator.
Well, the countdown was interesting. I guess added a little bit of suspense and drama because it looked like we were almost face-to-face with exactly the situation we had on Thursday with the upper-level winds. But how did they work through that? It sounded like they were busy in Denver working software to try to help us get a program that would
get us to launch. Exactly. We had a great countdown today, very smooth countdown for the launch vehicle. We had no launch vehicle anomalies. The Delta II rocket absolutely is a gem in getting it ready to launch. The range, we had a beautiful range today. All downrange assets were operational. Our spacecraft was ready to go, had no SV issues. So the only issue we were working throughout the count was upper level winds again. And we briefly went green about midway through the count, right as we were doing LOX loading. Then put another balloon up and got red data again. And as you mentioned, we worked our way through that.
Right now we've got one more launch replay we want to show you, which was taken from Port Canaveral down at Jetty Park of the launch earlier this morning at 9:08.